Now that you've had a chance to see and use the new 3.5 user interface, this is the first in a series of deep dive videos, and in this one, it's about tank levels. Let's start with the brief page. It can show up to four different fluid types here in the centre. In most cases, we expect people will use the first gauge to see battery level, and then the other three to show tank levels, like in this example, fuel, fresh water and wastewater. Depending on personal preference, you can set it to show the total in volumes, percentages, or just as a label. The brief screen shows the total for all the selected fluid types. For example, if a large yacht has port, starboard and stern fresh water, it'll give one total for all water on board. To see more detail, there is the levels page. Here is an example system which has two tanks, a diesel and freshwater tank. It shows the levels as a bar graph, as well as its percentage, remaining volume, and total capacity of the tank. For bigger boats and RVs that have multiple tanks and have the same fluid type within the setup, they are merged to make it easier to see at a glance what's going on. Here you can see this boat has three fuel tanks. If you click on the type, it shows the individual tank levels in detail. You can see in this example, there is a day tank at 40%, a port side tank at 8% and a starboard tank at 45%. You will notice there are red and orange levels. These automatically change colour depending if a tank is nearly empty where fluid is used, like a diesel or water tank, or nearly full, for example with a black or grey tank. We've tried to keep the tank level screen as simple and as clear as possible, so at a quick glance you can see how full or empty your tanks are.